On the 10th of July 1945, the German U-boat U-530 appeared quite unexpectedly off the Argentinian port of Mar del Plata and surrendered. This was the subject of my previous film. Her arrival created quite a stir, with rumours of German submarines landing gold bullion or Nazi fugitives on the shores of Argentina. But just as the furore started to die down, an even more incredible event occurred. Another German U-boat put into Mar del Plata and surrendered. The date was the 17th of August 1945, and the U-boat was U-977. Germany had surrendered on the 8th of May, so where had this boat been, and was there a connection with the previous arrival U-530? U-977 was a smaller type of submarine than U-530, a Type 7C U-boat. Commissioned in May 1943, her captain was Oberleutnant Heinz Schäfer, and he told an incredible story. According to Schäfer, the end of the war in Europe decided him upon a course of action. He said he had departed Kristiansand in Norway on a combat patrol to the English Channel on the 2nd of May 1945 and was outbound when he learned of the German surrender. He and his crew decided to make for Argentina instead of becoming prisoners of war, but first he landed 16 crew, mostly married men who didn't want to leave Europe, by dinghy on the 10th of May in Norway. U-977 then sailed submerged, using her snorkel for air and to run her diesels and recharge her batteries for an astounding 66 days, until the 14th of July 1945, when U-977 surfaced at the Cape Verde Islands of West Africa. On the 23rd of July, U-977 crossed the equator and arrived at Mar del Plata on the 17th of August after 108 days at sea. The problem is, this story is just that, a story. Schäfer wrote down what happened following interrogation in a book published in Argentina in Spanish in 1950. It was very limited in circulation, and in 1952, an expurgated version minus 25,000 words was published in Europe after permission was received from the British and Americans, establishing the familiar story largely believed today. The Argentinian Navy interrogation files were declassified in 2002, and they and the book's first largely unknown edition recount a quite different story. U-977 actually left Bergen in Norway on the 10th of May 1945, not the 2nd, 2 days after the German surrender. Schäfer said he was under specific orders from Grand Admiral Karl Dönitz, head of the Navy, and now the President of Germany after Hitler's death. The U-boat went to Frederikshavn in Denmark, where it took on a vast amount of cargo. The cargo, said Schäfer, consisted of vast quantities of food in tins, jars, etc. There was so much cargo that Schäfer was forced to put off 16 crewmen to try and make space. But the material also caused problems with trimming the boat at sea. Living conditions for the remaining 32 men aboard were extremely cramped. The reason for this vast amount of food is not given, but will be speculated upon later in this video. U-977 then made for the Iceland Passage between Scotland and Iceland on course 300 degrees. Once in the Atlantic, Schäfer reported encountering an aircraft and a ship, diving both times and being caught by direction-finding beams several times in late May, as Allied warships continued to search for missing German U-boats. This means his later claim to have travelled submerged for 66 days is a lie. He crossed the equator on the 4th of July 1945, not on the 23rd of July, as he later wrote, and was off the city of Rio de Janeiro on the 10th of July. He arrived at Mar del Plata on the 17th of August. So what happened between the 10th of July off Rio and his surrender at Mar del Plata on the 17th of August? Schäfer never explained these missing 38 days. The distance between the two cities is 1,300 kilometres. Even travelling submerged at snorkel speed of 3 knots, it would take the submarine barely 9 days to arrive at Mar del Plata, not 38. So what happened? Why did his boat linger in Argentinian territorial waters for week after week? What was his mission? The mystery deepens when we find out that when U-977 surrendered, her cargo was missing. Schaefer provided no answers. All 11 torpedoes were still aboard, but of the vast amounts of supplies which had caused Schaefer to land some of his crew and had interfered so much with the trim of the boat, that had simply vanished into thin air. Was there any relationship with U-530, the submarine that had surrendered earlier? Both submarines had followed similar courses to Argentina. Was there a German operation underway at war's end to move some unidentified things to Argentina? In the case of U-530, her forward and aft torpedo rooms were empty, as if cleared to carry cargo or passengers. Was U-977's mission to carry food and other supplies to Argentina? It would certainly appear to be likely if she left overloaded, couldn't account for 38 days in Argentinian territorial waters, and then surrenders empty of cargo. Were other submarines involved? Perhaps U-977 was the provisions boat for Patagonian U-boats coming down from Norway and Germany. Declassified Argentinian Navy documents state that U-235 also visited Argentina. This vessel was listed in Kriegsmarine records as having been sunk accidentally by a German torpedo boat in the Kattegat of Denmark in April 1945. However, the wreck of U-235 has not been located. This throws up more questions than answers. What U-977 and the other German U-boats were doing in Argentinian waters will probably remain a mystery forever. One final point. Even today, in 2018, 51 German World War II U-boats are listed as missing in action, meaning they have never been found. 8 disappeared after the 1st of January 1945. The more you look into these U-boat operations, the more intriguing the story becomes. But I'll leave you to decide what was going on. Many thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this film. If you have, please do support me on Patreon, subscribe, and also share. Many thanks.